The deformations, which are to the tune of 10 to 12 millimeters, they want to be properly represented. And there came the role of Williams. Williams said that no, we will not plot the structure, we will plot the display space. And he also further observed that since the members, the elongations are much, much less than the mean length of the members, he told that without drawing the arc, the arcs are almost at right angles to this. And so, for convenience of speedy solution, he told that because of no arcs, we can drop perpendiculars as well to get almost the same point. So, three things are important. First thing is, the member lengths and the displacements, they cannot be plotted in the same scale, cannot be represented appropriately in the same scale. That was our point number one. Point number two is that these, we decided to plot only the displacements, not the main structure. That is point number two. Point number three is we are going to for a simplification with the arcs we replaced by perpendiculars. Am I clear? So now when Williams looks at this problem, what does he say? He says that a condition that the structure must have at least two points in the displacement field known here. If you assume that A is your point of reference, then you take this point as A. B, in AB there is no member. Means B cannot move with respect to A. And therefore, B is again the same point. Because when he has eliminated the member itself, then these are now relative displacements. If this is A, this is C1. If you eliminate this, I will take off the member. So that C1 will go there. And that will be just the elongation of the relative displacement. Do you get me? Point A has been plotted here, which does not suffer any translation. Point B has again been plotted there, because B is a different point. There is no point, there is no member in AB. Had there been a member, it is not having any force. Means there is no relative displacement. And therefore, A and B are the same plane in this vector space. Am I clear? Now, I know that C is connected to A and B by two members. So I stand at A. I look towards C. I see that this member is in tension. So I understand that C will go away from me. Am I clear? I'm standing at A. I am looking at C. I know AC is in tension. A is a hinge point, it cannot move. I am not moving because I am standing at A, but the member is in tension, then C is going away from me. Let C go away from me. So from A, C, this line is nothing but parallel with this line. Okay. Now I again stand at B. Look at C. BC is in tension. And I understand that C will go away from me in this direction. And therefore, C2, which has gone away from me. And this line is nothing but parallel to 2. This way. Now, I draw perpendiculars. They meet at the point, which is C. I do not make that a C1, because the member itself is missing. I have not used the expression C in this diagram. So why should I use C here? Not only that. So that is C. So this is my reference A, this is C. This is the deformation of C with respect to A. Means this is the vertical, and this is the horizontal with respect of C with respect to A. Is it clear? But you are using it. একদম সব জিনিস আমি এদিকে দাঁড়ালাম, আমার দুটো পয়েন্ট দরকার, আমি এদিকে ঠিক তাকাতে শুরু করলাম, দেখলাম ওখানে বি পয়েন্ট আমাদের মুভ করেনি, তাহলে মুভ পয়েন্ট আবার আমাদের ডিসপ্লেসমেন্ট জিরো, diagram, who are Ami Acuant? They are the Acuant because they were not really responsible. Ever see a theater? A theke C moves away, B theke C moves away. Then A theke, Ami C1 ke problem, AC1 in the direction, in this direction. It can go along that because I'm taking an area. But A and B come on, no. C has moved away from it. She can be after. But B to the area of C has moved away from it. But each after. Okay, this is a particular problem. Yes. Even I took one from the question.
Horizontal displacement. Horizontal displacement.
Horizontal displacement. Horizontal displacement. I'm going to magnify it. So if this A and B are there, now I look at the point B. AB is in tension, means B moves away from E. EB is in compression, means B is moving towards
the. বলছি আমরা তো এখানে মানে জানি না যে কম্প্রেশন হবে টেনশন হবে সব কিছু মানে আগে আমরা ট্রাস্টটা সলভ করার পর এটা
আসছে ট্রাস্টটা সলভ করব ক্লাসের ইন্টিগ্রাল মেম্বার লেন্থের একটা শর্ট পার কারণ আমরা উদ্দেশ্য করতে মেম্বার ডিফাংশন পার করা নাও আমার উদ্দেশ্য জয়েন্ট মুভমেন্ট পার ইন্টার টেনশন মানে সরে গেল আর থেকে দাঁড়ালো আমি কিনতে দাঁড়িয়ে আছি দেখলাম ফিটটা অপারেশন মানে আমার দিকে চলে গেল ঠিক আছে অর্ডার ঠিক আছে আমি এতে দাঁড়ালাম এই মেম্বার কিসে আছে
টেনশন
হবে সরে যাবে আমি এতে দাঁড়িয়ে আছি আজকে কিনতে দাঁড়িয়ে আছি ওই বিটা কি করবো বলো আমার চলে আছে So I draw a normal, the inhibitor point, and that will give me the points.
Who's this?
Eva, what's the second thing?
D, tension.
D, tension. Can we get a D? Is connected to the D? Jacob, okay, jump there. I mean, what's the B? Because A and E are known. and B is connected to both end. So I have one find out, I want to plot D. Well, from B, D is in tension, so now find. So that is D1, and from E, D is in compression, so they will come towards. So they will come towards. So that is D2. You draw a normal. You draw a normal, and that is positive. Any doubt?
No.
Okay, so D is also. Now I want to attack point E. Now if I stand at B, C is away from me. So if I stand here, C is away from me. If I stand at D, then C is towards me.
Compression then D.
So C is towards me. I draw a normal. I draw an orbit and meet at the point C. You want to meet more, sir? We have displacement of, I know by reference is this. You need one of the people, I don't need a kind of stress. But the inter vertical, the inter horizontal. Two need the moment, sir, how many T point of displacement of that? So the peak of that is zero peak one.
স্যার সি টু পয়েন্টটা কি করে পাবো সি টু টা
সি টু পয়েন্টটা সি টু পয়েন্টটা আমি কাকে গেছি জি থেকে গেছি কিন্তু ডি থেকে সি থেকে তাকাও কি আসছে
কম্প্রেশন তখন
কম্প্রেশন তাহলে ডি থেকে তাকালে সিটা সরে যাবে কাছে আসবে
না চলে আসবে কাছে আসবে
কাছে আসবে আমি এই দিকে বলে বাদ দিয়ে আসবে
হ্যাঁ বাদ দিকে
ডি থেকে বাদ দিয়ে I draw a perpendicular, and this is my point. target point C. BC is in tension, means C will go away from B. Let C go away from B. The elongation of this member BC is basically BC one in a certain scale. If you look at this member is in tension.
Tension.
So C will go away from B. You know the elongation of BC.
Yes.
Perpendicular scale. So you stand at D and you realize that C will go away. C will move away from it. So that is C. So draw normal. But this is that.